The early 1930s saw the most extravagant aircraft with unique shapes and sizes as part of a widely experimental phase in the aviation industry. And still, the Stipa-Caproni stood apart. The inventive airframe, designed by Italian aeronautical engineer Luigi Stipa and manufactured by the Caproni Company, was in many ways like a cartoon aircraft, but it was functional. The so-called flying barrel consisted of a mere tube for a fuselage and an engine and propeller that washed the airflow through the cylinder's length, creating thrust. Some experts considered the Stipa-Caproni the ugliest aircraft ever built, while others still call it an aerodynamic aberration. Still, there is reason to suggest that the bizarre concoction was the direct predecessor of the modern turbofan engine. National pride. In 1932, the Italian fascist government was interested in showcasing its own technology, particularly the successful advances in domestic aviation. Conveniently, inventor Luigi Stipa approached them with a unique idea that same year. Stipa had interrupted his education to serve with the Italian Army's Bersaglieri Corps in World War I. Afterward, he resumed his studies and earned several degrees, including civil, hydraulic, and aeronautical engineering. The young inventor then started working for the Air Ministry and eventually became General Inspector of the Air Force Engineering Division. Intrigued with the advances of the time, Stipa devoted himself to a new theory to make aircraft more efficient. As a hydraulic engineer, he was familiar with the Bernoulli principle, a reasonably well-known axiom from the 1920s that stated that the velocity of a fluid increased as the diameter of the tube narrowed. Stipa then started exploring the relationship between the velocity and the pipe diameter to airflow. His objective was to increase an engine's efficiency, and he began by directing the prop wash through a Venturi tube and creating what he called an intubated propeller. After years of hard work, the creator finally arrived at the optimum shape for the tube's prop and leading edge. Incidentally, the device's inner surface was almost identical to an airfoil. Stipa published his findings in the Rivista Aeronautica along with the design for a small single-engine testbed aircraft. He then petitioned the government to fund the research and development of a real-life model. Despite the radical nature of the design, both in looks and construction, the fascist regime actively encouraged technological development. Now, it was just a matter of finding the right company to build such a rare aircraft. Out of the box. The first Italian airplane was built by Count Gianni Caproni di Taliedo in 1910. Within 4 years, he had also made the world's first single-seat tractor engine fighter, armed with a forward-firing machine gun. During World War I, Caproni focused on producing his signature line of giant aircraft, earning a reputation as a bold, unafraid aircraft developer. Even after the war, the Count continued to create huge multi-wing airplanes, such as his unforgettable 8-engined, 9-winged CA-60 airliner, while also developing a full range of more average models. Simply put, Caproni was deemed the perfect option to carry out Stipa's project. In 1932, the Air Ministry contacted the Caproni Aviation Corporation to develop and build the prototype. The design consisted of a short, fat, tubular shape, open at the front and back, but narrowed in the middle, so that the air was compressed and pushed in by the propeller. Notably, the tube was basically the fuselage, giving the aircraft a comic appearance. Moreover, the elliptical-shaped set of wings looked small, mated to the tube, and they required spars passing through the tube and the engine nacelle in the center. In addition, the cockpit housed a pair of tandem seats in a hump on top of the tubular fuselage. However, the line of sight was less than ideal, with the humped surfaces at the front and rear hampering the view, significantly restricting takeoff and landing. In terms of power, a single 120-horsepower de Havilland Gypsy 3 engine was mounted in a nacelle with the propeller at the leading edge and suspended inside the tube center. Furthermore, the aircraft required relatively low landing gear since the propeller was about the same diameter as the fuselage. Finally, a small rudder and elevators were attached to the tube's trailing edge directly in the slipstream. And to further emphasize the aircraft's caricature-esque look, it was painted in a light blue and cream color scheme, much like racing planes at the time, Bumblebee. When Caproni test pilot Domenico Antonini first flew the aircraft in October of 1932, the Stipa-Caproni was a startling sight. Oddly proportioned, the experimental aircraft had a wingspan of 46 feet 10 inches, a height of 9 feet 10 inches, and a length of barely 19 feet 3 inches. Also, its top speed was 81 miles per hour. Stipa demonstrated a better climb rate than conventional aircraft with similar power and wing loading. In fact, the test flights confirmed that the intubated propeller increased engine efficiency and the interior airfoil shape contributed to lifting. Also, the chubby aircraft was noticeably quieter than similarly powered aircraft. Ultimately, the Bumblebee proved superior to other aircraft with similar engine ratings. Stipa's design not only had a faster rate of climb, but was extremely stable in flight. Perhaps too stable, as some pilots found it difficult to change course. Still, the aircraft's docile handling was widely praised. But the designer might have overestimated the effectiveness of the rudder and elevators, as they had to be enlarged. The bizarre airframe also came with a series of drawbacks. The tube propeller suffered from excessive drag, thus negating the aircraft's otherwise advantageous aerodynamics. And for a reasonably sized single-engined aircraft, the drag absolutely negated the configuration's benefits. Nevertheless, the Stipa-Caproni was always meant to be a testbed, and proved successful at that. In fact, its creator intended to use the design to produce larger, multi-engined aerial vehicles, even sketching numerous blueprints. Some of them even had six engines, but none were ever built. After the initial testing, the prototype was delivered to the Air Force, which continued with its own test program. The results were of great academic interest, even drawing the attention of the National Advisory Committee for Aeronautics, or NACA, which closely studied the concept. However, no further development was undertaken. Copyright. Encouraged by the interest in his project from the Italian government and the aeronautics community, Stipa patented his design not only in his country, but also in the United States and Germany. Ultimately, however, the strange construction did not offer any real advantages over its contemporaries and was soon abandoned. However, even though the Air Ministry did not embrace the inventor's theories, the Italians still publicized them as propaganda, and his work was published in many countries, including France and the United Kingdom. In 1934, German engineer Ludwig Kort patented a ducted fan similar in principle to its Italian counterpart. This so-called Kort nozzle system is still used today. Notably, the French also became interested in the Italian model and commissioned the development of a night bomber with intubated propellers based on Stipa's designs. The BN-4 night bomber, built by ANF Moreau, would have carried a crew of four and featured retractable landing gear and two power-operated gun turrets. With a wingspan of 59 feet, a top speed of 233 miles per hour, a range of 1,242 miles, and a ceiling of 33,136 feet, the model could actually have redeemed Stipa, but the nationalization and reorganization of the aviation industry in France put down the project before a prototype could even be built. Moreover, after the development of the V-1 flying bomb some time later, Stipa claimed that the Germans had stolen his patents. However, their pulse jet engine bore little resemblance to his intubated propeller and actually used controlled explosions instead. Legacy. Not much is known about the mysterious 1940 Hinkle T-Fighter beyond a few sketches. Still, it evoked Stipa's creations in many ways, and was designed for an engine developed by the originator of the flying saucer, a title popularly attributed to the Australian crackpot Victor Schauberger. No further efforts were made to develop Stipa's intubated propeller, but in 1940, the Italians flew a more advanced derivative, the Caproni Campini N1. The new aircraft used a conventional radial engine to power a variable-pitch ducted fan compressor inside the fuselage. The system required additional fuel in the compressed air, which burned in a combustion chamber in the tail. While the N1 was never practical, it did give the Italians the right to brag about having flown the first aircraft with an afterburner. Then, after the end of World War II, Stipa was convinced that the jet engine was derived from his designs, and several historians also acknowledge the similarities between the tube propeller and turbofan engines, vindicating the Italian inventor and his creation to an extent. Stipa remained embittered in the lack of recognition for the rest of his life, but Lynette Zuccoli and Aerotech Queensland in Australia worked hard to continue the Italian's legacy after his demise in 1992, building a 3/5 scale replica of the original Stipa-Caproni, complete with its same paint scheme. The aircraft was flown at least twice before being retired to static display, and it can be visited at Toowoomba City Aerodrome in Australia. Thank you for watching our video. Before you go, don't forget to check out all our documentaries channels for many more exciting military-inspired stories. Also, please give us a thumbs up and click on the bell icon to be notified of our newest content. Stay tuned.